Hi, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. This video covers the unboxing of an HEQ5 Pro telescope mount by Skywatcher. Now this mount's been around for a few years and I've used one in a garden observatory setup. It's a popular choice for astronomers wanting the convenience of a go-to mount that offers good stability whilst also being reasonably portable. So the package arrives in two boxes, one containing the mount head and the other the tripod. So let's take a look. So let's open up the big box. So this will be a box inside box. Again, a long box inside box contains the tripod. So securely. Here we go. So there's the tripod, which is nicely packaged in foam to protect either end of it and wrapped in a plastic bag. And the tripod itself, I think it weighs around 5 kilos. So it's quite rigid, it's got the 1.75 inch diameter steel legs. Inside the box we've also got a spreader bar, so that's going to attach into the middle of the tripod to allow the legs to brace securely and for us to tighten the whole assembly up. And there's also another box, quite heavy this one, about as heavy as the tripod, which is a clue to what's inside. So nicely wrapped in foam, we've got a counterweight. So we'll see that later when we assemble the mount. So taking a look at the spacer bar a little closer, it attaches, obviously bracing against the legs, and you can tighten it with this knob underneath. But it's worth noting that there's a single bolt that's basically going all the way up through the centre of the tripod head. So if I tilt this over, hopefully you can see that this thread, the idea is that you'll screw the bolt and use it to attach the bottom of the tripod head onto the tripod itself, and then tighten all the spacer bar up. Other things to note is there's an alignment pin to locate the orientation of the mount head, and there's an identification that leg is basically going to be pointed towards north. Obviously this is an equatorial mount. So what about the second box? Well, let's take a look. Okay, so first off we have a set of instructions for this mount. So it's a manual covering the HEQ5 and the EQ6 mounts. We've got an attachment strap here, which we'll see the purpose of that in a little bit. If we remove the foam, we can see the main content. So inside we've got the mount head itself, all wrapped up in a plastic bag. We've got the remote control handset, and we've got some cables. So here I can see there's going to be cables for power and also to connect the handset. What else? Well, I think this is a rather nice dovetail bar. So recently Skywatcher have made small change to the mount. They've coloured this green, and there's some other green parts on the side of the mount, which I think makes it look quite smart. Other than that, we've just got a couple of adjustment bolts, and we'll see the function of those when we put the mount together. So if we remove all the packaging and we lift the mount head out of the polystyrene, then first thing you notice, other than the fact that it's several kilos of mount, is that it's free to rotate. So it's shipped in a position that's 180 degrees from its normal use, so you can rotate this part and you can see here that there are, there's a clamp to allow us to stop that rotation. So just having a quick look, you can see this is where we're going to attach the mount head to the tripod. Here, if I release this clamp, we can see that the counterweight is going to attach here on this counterweight bar, that it ships in a nicely retracted position. We can also see that there is a bubble level here at the bottom of the mount, and that the declination axis has another clamp, and that the dovetail is going to be secured by two bolts. Looking at the connections, we can see there is a connection for a hand controller to apply the 12 volt DC power, on off switch, and auto guider connection. So continuing with the assembly, we take the mount head and we locate it onto that pin that we saw previously on top of the tripod, and then whilst holding onto the head, we slowly screw the thread of the attachment bolt from underneath until you can feel that it is locating inside the mount head above, like so, and keep screwing it all the way to the top, tighten it up, then returning to the spreader bar, attach that, and then there's a washer and a big plastic nut, so attach that finally at the bottom of the assembly, tighten it all together, and then we're ready to attach the counterweights. Okay, so just to finish off the other bits and pieces we've got in the box, we saw we've got a plastic bracket here to hold the hand controller, and we can attach that with a Velcro strap around one of the legs, like so. Hand controller itself, which comes with a cable which you can click into the like so, into the bottom of the hand controller, and then a similar connector at the other end which goes into the mount like so, and then you can put the controller onto the bracket. And then finally, we have a 12 DC power cable, which will attach into the mount like so. And it comes with a cigar lighter type fitting to attach to a power supply. So now I've threaded in the two bolts that came with the mount. So one here into the back of the mount and another one here on the front, and basically the purpose of these two bolts is to allow us to adjust the angle of the polar axis of the mount. So they act in a kind of push-pull arrangement, so if I loosen off this bolt here and then turn this one, you can see hopefully that the angle of the mount is increasing like so, and then if I tighten the other one then and loosen this one, then we can reduce the angle of the mount. And eventually, once you've got the polar axis of the mount pointed towards the north celestial pole or the south celestial pole, then you can lock these two bolts together to hold them out securely. So that's it, Skywatcher HEQ5 Pro mount unboxed. Hope this video has been useful. Please subscribe to my Gentleman's Astro YouTube channel if you'd like to see more Astro videos. And thanks for watching.